Good evening, ladies and gentlemen and students. Please rise for the pledge to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Students, you may be seated. For tonight's welcome address of the 2021 graduation ceremony, I'm pleased to introduce to you the Director of Innovation, Bill Hogan.
Welcome, parents, grandparents, guardians, staff, and most of all, those students receiving the Boone County District Diploma, Class of 2021. It's been a strange year. For you guys, it's been a strange 2 years. And I'm reminded of a coach that told somebody that was important to me one time, that opportunity, never let it pass you. And every barrier you overcome, is that an opportunity for greatness? You'll face barriers, you'll face walls, you'll face challenges. Understand that that's your opportunity to shine, your opportunity to be better than anybody else. If you have the right frame of mind, challenge yourself and overcome any obstacle. You've done that for the past 2 years. For some of you, you've done it your whole life. And you're going to have to continue to do that. I appreciate your perseverance, your grit, to make it to this point. No matter what, you made it. Tonight is your night. We appreciate you. I want to share my thanks, my gratitude to Dr. Hibbett, to his staff for their hard work day in and day out. To the teachers and the staff at the virtual program, thank you for your hard work. To the Board of Education who's here tonight, thank you. Thank you for your support, your commitment to do something that 6 years ago graduated 11 kids. 11 students 6 years ago through this program received their diploma. Tonight we have 173 students graduating with the district diploma. We have 10 more in the wings hoping to graduate and finish by June 30th. Our goal is well over 200 next year. We appreciate the visionary leadership of Mr. Gels, who started this program, and his foresight to see that we needed to offer an alternative way for students to gain their diploma. It is a significant, significant thing you've done, and don't ever forget it. There's on to better things, and tonight I would like to recognize Logan Moore. Logan, if you're present, would you stand up? Chris Sanger, who is unable to be with us, and Courtney Waggy. These three students are moving on to the military. So as a veteran, thank you. Thank you. Others will go on to do great things. For those wearing the cords tonight and have participated in dual credit, would you stand up? Don't be shy, stand up. These students took an opportunity to attend Gateway Community and Technical College and start earning their associate's degree or their bachelor's degree at a much cheaper cost than you'll pay starting tomorrow. So I appreciate your willingness to do that and challenge yourself. Even though you may not have a cord, you may not be going to the military, please live your dream. Please overcome the obstacles, and when somebody tells you you can't, show them that you can. I appreciate each and every one of you. Parents, thank you for allowing us to help with raising your child. We know we've done a great job because they made it to this point. So thank you very much. I appreciate everybody being here tonight. Dr. Hibbett.
I'd like to ask our next speaker, student Eli Nunez, to come up to the podium. As he's walking up, I've had the privilege of knowing Eli personally since he was in the sixth grade. And what Mr. Hogan spoke about, he embodies and personifies. And I asked him to give his speech tonight to you all, the graduates, as a symbol of perseverance and fortitude. Thank you.
Welcome to all fellow graduates. I am me. I may not see much, but I have seen much, and in my life I have been through more. I am me. I ask you to see me as a student in the past, a student who was seen as failing and heard of as disruptive. I constantly heard of my potential but couldn't see my potential. So many, my mom, my teachers fought for me, but I didn't fight for myself. I was expelled from school, rightly so. Now I ask you to see me as a student now. I am graduating because I hashtag rise up. I rise up to work my job as a manager every day. I rise up to accomplish my goal of succeeding in life every day. I rise up and stand here before you to say, wherever you are in life, rise up. I am me. I am Eli Nunez. Thank you.
And now I have the privilege to introduce to you tonight our keynote speaker, Representative Mr. Ed Massey of the Kentucky House of Representatives.
Thank you. It's certainly a pleasure to be here tonight. I always take one additional point of personal privilege, and I'm going to ask everyone in this auditorium that has served either in the armed forces, our police, or firefighters groups to please stand and be recognized. I always do that for several reasons. One is because I think we often forget that the reason we can be here in this country, in this state, in this nation, to exercise our freedoms is because of those who have paid that price. So I want to offer a personal thank you. Now, to all the graduates, I've had the opportunity to do this a few times because before I was a state representative, I served on the Boone County School Board for 22 years. And I enjoyed every moment of that. But I have to say that I really enjoy this program because to me, those of you that have gone the additional way and have done the additional grind and have persevered and pushed yourself through to excellence is not only admirable, but is inspirational. And I want to thank you for never, ever giving up. I'm going to talk about something that might seem unique to education. We often talk, or we're taught when we're young, that we need to seek to be A students. But I'm going to tell you that A's are not always the most important thing in life. And tonight, I'm going to talk about F's and how the F student can be successful. And here's what I mean. The first F in my five is faith. You have to believe, and you have to believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, don't believe that anyone else will. The fact that you're here tonight, graduating, shows that you exercised that faith. And for that, I commend you. Secondly, is family. You didn't get here alone. You didn't enter this life alone. And you have family that have supported you when it wasn't necessarily easy to support you. I have family that supports me, and I can assure you that it's not always easy to support me because I'm involved in a lot of things, and I have a lovely wife and three beautiful daughters and now a granddaughter and one on the way. And it really takes all of us working together. So to those parents out here, thank you for never giving up, for your commitment, your dedication, your perseverance, and for picking your child up when they didn't want to get up. And to you students, thank you again for bouncing back up, and never let it be said that you're not as equally as important and as equally as admirable as anyone else. The third F is friends. Tonight, you will graduate. And I look back on my graduation many years ago, 1985, and I remember that some of those people that I had spent the previous 11 or 12 years with, I never saw them again after I left at graduation. Now, some you may never want to see again, but for those you do want to see again, stay in touch, because friends can help you when no one else can. Friends can help you when a parent cannot. Friends can be there to pick you up and to push you on. The fourth F is finances. Now, why would I mention finances? Because this is a world where finances are necessary to fulfill our dreams, whether it's just having a place to live, a car to drive, or some money to spend, but it's going to be important to your future. So be mindful of that. There are many people that get to the latter parts of their life and they don't have anything left to show or to share. So be mindful of your finances. And finally, your future. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. Think about that. You can't undo your past. No matter what you've done in your past, it cannot be undone. We can't hit the restart button every day. What you have is what you've experienced, and your experience is what will make you great. But tomorrow is a new day when you'll graduate, when you'll walk forward. Some of you will go to the service, some of you will go to jobs, some of you will go to higher education. But you are the future, not only of this community, but of this state and of this country. And I never forget that. So some of you will be able to help others where no one else can. Some of you have had experiences that have molded you and shaped you. Just use those for the good. Now, I'm not going to go on and on, because even though I'm a lawyer and sometimes people say we get paid by the word, not true. But I will say this. I've often learned when you're speaking to the public that you're not the thing they want to hear or see. They want to get on with the show. And I've also learned that the mind cannot absorb what the buttocks cannot endure. So with that, I want to share my congratulations to you as a former school board member and as a representative in the Kentucky House of Representatives. We honor you, we salute you, and this is your proud day. Enjoy it.
Public education is a beautiful thing. And without the staff that I want to recognize by name momentarily, what you see before you would not be possible. So I'd like to acknowledge, and this is on the back of your graduation program, Vice Principal Melissa Lehmeyer, school counselors Tammy Dorgan, the virtual school counselor Rhonda Dawson, our school psychologist Alan Mullins, our school services coordinator Catherine Brenthop, our school secretary Patricia Rodriguez, our staff support Laura Janes, our custodian Charlie Bufano, our school nurse Lindsay Snyder, and our school resource officer, Officer Kevin Gilpin. For the teachers, I would like to recognize first the virtual teachers, Jessica Gels, Ashley Hibbett, Chris Johnson, and Leslie Walters. For the classroom teachers, Mr. Brown, Tevis Gray, Mr. Steck, Mary Cockrell, Amanda Johnson, Melissa Warner, Nathan Cottrell, Shamika Overstreet, Tanya Young, Joseph Gormley, and Matthew Shear. Last, I would like to thank our school choice coordinator, Mrs. Schaefer, who sits individually on every one of the meetings of the students before us to get them to and from these type of programs. Let's give all of them a round of applause. Now for one of the parts you've been waiting for, our student recognition and the presentation of diplomas.
Cody Abibu. Haley Barnhart. Reagan Grace Lynn Booth. Jermaine Brown. John David Bruce. Albany Breeze Centers. Elijah Robert Lee Cook. Devin Crawford. Kailila Tyann Creed. Justin Tyler Dean. Yeah. Nomi Delgado. Hallie Jean Deeney. Jackson Ryan Egan. Caleb Braden Earls. McKenna Ashton Ellis. Cameron Joseph Inda. Kaylin Mason Espy. Sierra Michelle Floyd. Tyler Nicholas Garcia. Stephen Thomas Gloom. Brianna Rose Gonzalez. Deanna Marie Good. Dalton Andrew Head. Nina Alexandria Hernandez. Talia Hernandez. Dylan Philip Heinzman. Trayton Jefferson Holbrook. Micah Allen Hollingsworth. Micah Grant Holmes. Zylisha Idrisha Housley. Jonathan Gerald Jones. Drew Allen Kemper. Savannah Marie Klein. Jaden Brian Loftman. Zoe Jewel Laycock. Taylor Nicole Leitner. Alexis Marie McDowell. Caleb Hunter McGreevy. William Asher McGregor. Jacob Allen Melvin. K. Kieran Thomas Memorine. Ian Taylor Wendell Middleton. Alexandra Marie Moore. Ashley Marie Moore. Logan Michael Moore. Elizabeth Cadence Moreland. Abigail Faye Morris. Dylan Robert Musgrave. Selman Music. Eli Randall Rodrigo Nunez. Ronnie Alexis Ochoa. Leslie Yorisa Patino. Evan Jordan Petticord. Dylan Cole Perez. Madison K. Pettit. Kevin Allen Joseph Pfeiffer. Parker Alexander Pittman. Isabella Ray Ponchot. Jalen Hope Ponchot McDaniel. John Aiden Pottinger. Raphael Reynolds. Eunice Ronham. Isaiah Joseph Roberts. Kayla Lynn Rouse. William Clark Russell. Kyla Pearl Sams. Jacob Thomas Sandoval. Gage Michael Shepherd. Miguel Silva. Yeah. Logan Davis Snodgrass. Alaric Jean Steffens. Sarah Rose Stevie. Michaela Elizabeth Stewart. Rita Nicole Streese. Wyatt Lee Stubman. Cole Jarrett Sullivan. Gabriel Xavier Talent. Jaden Connor Thompson. Amber Dawn Turtlot. Brian Trejo. Alexander Turgeon. Jaleesha Lynn Walls. Megan Petra Whistle. Chase Logan White. Kayla Shea Widener. Aubrey Michelle Nicole Williams. Sean Romero Williams. Nathaniel Ryan Wilson. Brian Alexander York. Courtney Carissa Cars. Hunter Anthony Zeeks. Jordan Hill. Christina K. Willoughby.
Okay, I promise you the closing remarks will take no longer than about 4 minutes exactly. I have it timed pretty good. You know, when I think about this ceremony and what it stands for, I want the students, most of all, but the families, to be so proud of what they symbolize. And so I wrote something to hopefully give credit to that. They are the great American spirit, We hear it through the actions among students who sit before us, a chorus of "We shall overcome." You see, they give us hope through the fact that they finished what they begun, to become and not to be outdone. No, not by COVID, nor clotted by tough times and a problem. Their minds still solid, they solve them. Let us acknowledge their knowledge of how to get through life, their fight to break through the depths of a dark night and to rise to the height of this day. The light was more than just answering a bunch of questions on their test right. You see, we esteemed educators sometimes act as investigators of a five-letter word called rigor, and act to execute like a trigger the validation of their accomplishment. Not granted hard enough. Like we planned it, here's your diploma, but please don't touch. It is said a strand of three is not easily broken, so I say, take these three examples I'm about to give you and hold them in your mind and your heart. Let them bind and impart their mark of what truly is hard. Strand one, Jalicia, come see a student who rescued and trained therapy dogs in school while attaining A's in college classes. Let that fuel strand two, KK, once at the bottom pits, became and now stands before you a phlebotomist, seeking her LPN to end with strand three. Kayla raised her son, Hosea, while holding the fire hose to spray a fire, raise a ladder, and save ya in an emergency matter, now a firefighter and EMT. You see, these shatter the thought of not hard enough for me. And hard times teach us something. I mean, that's the essence of education. Let these students before us teach us something, like Mr. Massey spoke of. In all of our lives, we can't go back and change the beginning. None of us can. No one in this room. But we can start where we are and change the ending. And that's what they have done. And so with this, I proclaim an ending to this ceremony and victory. Class of 2021, please rise. Please move your tassels to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, I now pronounce the class to you of 2021, you are dismissed. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain in your seats until they get their diploma and they'll be back out for pictures.
Too fast to prepare for this, coming in the work of a danger is. Everybody circling is vulture is. Negative, negative.